Good evening. Welcome to the concert night. This is our small jazz band at Marshall High School. Just getting my A material. You don't want to hear my B stuff. So we're so grateful to Dr. Jojo for inviting us to play tonight and being the guests of the great SMSU jazz band. We were literally looking forward to hearing you as well. We're going to play three songs tonight. Snow has wreaked havoc on our rehearsal schedule. This band needs about 45 minutes a week. And with the number of snow days and things we've had, we've only had 2 full weeks since Christmas in school. So we have done the best we can, so we're going to play 2 rock tunes for you and a Latin chart. The first one is called Engine Number 9, and it will feature Olivia Hausman on saxophone, Scott Kriegel on saxophone, and there's some guitar from Carson Springer.
Thank you.
Our second song is a Beatles song. I'm a big Beatles fan, so we played Beatles last year, we played Beatles this year, we're stuck with that. But this is a piece called Lady Madonna. This will feature Austin Dunn on saxophone. Our final number, before we bring the SMC band up, will be a Latin piece called Un Poco Más. And this will feature Scott Griebel on saxophone, Jonah Vorbach on tuba, Austin Dunn on saxophone, Olivia Hausman on saxophone, Augie Sturck on saxophone, David Jimenez on saxophone, Carson Springworth on guitar, and a short solo from Jackson Lent on the drum set. Thank you again to Dr. Junker for having us over to play tonight. This will be our final number until we'll come back and have a surprise. Thanks.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Enchanted Bookshop. which will be opening this Saturday with shows of 11 o'clock and 2 o'clock, and on Sunday at 2 o'clock and 4 o'clock. So come see the Enchanted Bookshop. It sounds like a really fun show, and bring your kids, bring your grandkids. It's supposed to be really fun. So we're really glad that all of you could be here tonight. It was great to have the Marshall High School Jazz Band play for us. Really nice job. Can we give them another? It's really great to have that group here because it's a wonderful way to start a really exciting evening of music for you. The first tune that we played for you is one by Howard Rowe. It's kind of a takeoff on, you know, one of the big band standards called 1 o'clock Jump. This one was 1.5 o'clock Jump. And we're going to move on now to a tune written by the great Thad Jones. This is called It Only Happens Every Time. Thank you. Sorry, it's a long way around the band. So that piece was a nice little ballad called Closing Time. It's actually not on your program. I guess I lied when I wrote it. Decided it sounded good and we were going to play it. The next tune we're going to play for you is got a little bossa to it. It's got a little gospel. It's got a little ballad to it. The piece is by Mike Kamath, and it's called Too Soon to Go.
Thank you.
We have one more tune that we're going to play on our own before we bring our guest out. But before we play this, I just wanted to mention something in the programs. Hopefully there were enough programs up there. If not, and you don't have one, excuse you, just let me know and I'll be happy to send you a copy of it digitally. But in the programs, there's a half sheet of paper and it's a survey. We are blessed every year to receive a grant, an Arts in the Schools grant from the Southwest Minnesota Arts Council. They have been very generous in supporting this guest artist series for the past 16 years. And part of that grant process is that they want us reviewing what's happening. They want to get feedback on the events that we're putting on. How are audiences enjoying this? What are you getting out of the experience? As well as what the groups that are participating get out of it. So if you have a chance before you leave this evening, if you could fill out that survey and maybe just leave it on that music stand where all the programs were, we would really appreciate that. That will help us in providing our report to SMOC and hopefully continuing to get funding to do events like this each year. So we're going to finish up with a funk chart. This is called Morning Funk. Thank you. At this time, it's my great pleasure to welcome our guest for our guest jazz residency this year. Our guest this year is, well, he's played with just about everyone. He has played on thousands of albums, films, television shows, commercials. He's written literally thousands and arranged literally thousands of pieces, not only for groups that he's played in, but for others. He's written music for the closing ceremonies of the Olympics when they were in Atlanta. He's written arrangements and orchestrations for just about anything you can think of. In fact, earlier today I was commenting with one of our marketing people here on campus, and she said, you know, I bet you could say a name and he'd have a story to tell about that person. If it's any name in music that you've ever heard of, it seems like he's met him. In fact, on the radio this morning we were talking, and the radio person, Josh Goblish, I think he said something along the lines, it sounds like you played for like everybody. And he said, yeah, everybody except for Frank Sinatra. And they called me to play for him, but I already had a gig, so I had to turn him down. Okay, how big do you have to be to say no to Frank Sinatra, right? So it's been just an absolute pleasure to have this gentleman here. The knowledge and skills and stories that he can share with us have just been amazing. And on top of that, he's one of the nicest guys that you will ever meet. So please welcome our guest for this year, Mr. Tom Bones Malone.
Just all have great attitudes and want to learn and want to play music, and it's just been delightful. The next one is by a record that some of you people might remember, by Percy Sledge, "When a Man Loves a Woman." I was privileged to arrange this for him for the, when he was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Paul Schaefer's band was the house band for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame Awards for about 25 years, and I got to write arrangements for a lot of famous people. Made famous by Dizzy Gillespie, A Night in Tunisia. Thank you. Songs by a group called Chicago. Hard habit to break.
Thank you.
It's been such a pleasure working with these students this week, and I think they should be proud of themselves. I was a ranger for Saturday Night Live from 1975 to 1985, the first 10 years of the show. And spring of 1978, I was in a meeting with John Belushi and Dan Aykroyd, just the three of us. And they're talking about this, they're developing these characters that wear sunglasses day and night. And so they asked me to write an arrangement of a song called Rocket 88 by James Cotton. And so I wrote this arrangement and we rehearsed the Saturday Night Live band. And, we did it for Lorne Michaels, the producer, and didn't make the show, boom. So the next week, John and Danny are so hot on this idea about the Blues Brothers, and they're working out their costumes and their steps and their, you know, the whole routine. I arranged a song called Hey Bartender. We did it for Lorne Michaels, rehearsed the band, did it for Lorne Michaels. Lorne Michaels says, frankly, I don't see anything funny about the Blues Brothers. Week number two. So week number three, John and Danny gave up. They said, look, if Lauren doesn't like it, if we're not getting on the show, we're wasting our time. So they gave up on the Blues Brothers. The third week, Lauren comes out to read through about 3:15 on Wednesday. And we got a live show to do Saturday. It's not pre-taped or anything, it's all live. So Lauren comes out to read through about 3:15 on Wednesday and he says, the show is 3 minutes short. What are we gonna do? John and Danny jumped on. Lauren, the Blues Brothers. So Lauren said, we have nothing worthwhile to put in those 3 minutes. you guys might as well make fools of yourselves. You take a time. And I guess the rest is history. I'm going to do one of my favorite songs from the movie. I was privileged to arrange some music for the movie, and one of my favorites is called Sweet Home Chicago. And there's going to be some surprises later.
Thank you. Thank you.
it's not over yet. We've got one more piece. And we'd love to have the Marshall High School Jazz Band come up and join us on stage. This will take just a moment, because I forgot to warn them in advance. But that's okay. It gives me a little time to just tell you about a few things. First of all, tonight is the kickoff of this year's Fine Arts Celebration. This is something that the Department of Fine Arts Communication, along with the Creative Writing Program, have been doing for 17 years now. Tonight is the start. It runs through, I believe, May 6th. And there are just tons of concerts, drama productions, art exhibits, readings, forensics demonstrations. There are just tons of things that are going to be going on over the next 6 weeks. And there are Fine Arts Celebration posters that have been posted around town. There are several here on campus, including you'll pass at least one as you leave the building, so feel free to snap a picture of it so that you can see everything that's coming up. But we do hope that we'll see you at some of the other events that are part of that celebration. And so also one other thing I want to share with you, if you'd like to take a little piece of Bones Malone home with you, he brought with him a small supply of these t-shirts. Right here, nice little trombone on the front. I might be a little biased about that, but I think everyone needs a t-shirt with a trombone on the front. And on the back, a very highly abridged list of the artists that he has performed with, including the Blues Brothers, the David Letterman Show, the Saturday Night Live Band, Blood, Sweat, and Tears, Frank Zappa, Gil Evans, Billy Cobham, Paul McCartney, Miles Davis, and believe me, that list is a lot longer, like pages longer. So if you would like to purchase one of these t-shirts, they will be down front over here. They are $20. And so someone will be down there in a few minutes so that you can purchase these if you'd like. Okay, we're going to take a little musical adventure here. And Tom is going to join us on a solo on this as well. This is going to be an adventure because two groups have never played together on this tune. So that in itself is going to be interesting. Plus, I've never heard the high school group play it. So, you know, here's hoping everyone can keep up with each other. We're going to play a really nice chart by Horace Silver called I Want You. That was a close one. You were about to hear a scat solo.
Did they turn? Is this thing on? How about a big hand for John?
Thank you so much for coming tonight. Please drive safely as you leave. I'll turn on the lights in a moment, so don't hurt yourself.